Welcome to the More Than Fitness Podcast.
And welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to Minisode number 100. We did it, guys. We made it to Minisode 100. And if you're on the video podcast right now, you can see that I have some ridiculous 2020 glasses that have obviously, well, so I'm in my parents' basement right now for the holidays, right? And I was thinking for the 100th Minisode, I was like, I want to do something cool. I want to maybe wear like a little party hat. I want to, you know, maybe I was thinking about taking a shot of a bourbon or something, but it's also 11:49 a.m. on a Wednesday. So while I do like bourbon, I don't love it that much to take a shot just for you guys. So sorry about that. And who knows how many times I've got to do this take. So I might have to take a couple shots before I get it right. Even though that might be really interesting. But I was looking around, and as parents do, of course they have random holiday things like these 2020 glasses that I'm wearing right now that have clearly been on this countertop for literally almost a year, and now they're fogging up, and so I'm going to take those off. But yeah, if you want to check out the sweet sunglasses glasses that I was wearing, definitely check out the video podcast. Yeah, of course she had those lying around, so I was like, I'm just going to throw those on real quick, and we're going to finish out the new year, or the old year of 2020 strong, and we're going to finish it with Minisode number 100, and it's been a really cool experience. I started doing these Minisodes simply because I wanted to do a little bit more of the tactical, specific, nitty-gritty type stuff for you guys in a shorter format than the long guest podcast that I would do or a solo podcast. And it allowed me to dive deeper on specific topics. So that's how the Minisodes were born. And so thank you for everybody who's been here for these since the genesis of this. You guys remember me doing it at my desk in Lexington with Zion the Zebra, my little plant, my stack of books. I'll throw up a picture here so that you guys can reminisce with me a little bit. But it's been cool. I care, but I also don't care, because I know that whenever I started the podcast, I was like, catch me at episode 500. Not episode 100, right? Because I know that, like anything that's worthwhile, it takes a lot of time, and podcasting is a very long-term game. And so I was ready to do hundreds and hundreds of episodes before anybody even gave a fuck. And I think a few of you give a fuck, and I do appreciate you. And we're going to keep this train rolling with this 100th Minisode. I will get to some valuable stuff for you guys, because I was trying to figure out what to make this Minisode about. I didn't want to just come on here and reminisce and not really provide any value for you guys. So I also wasn't going to do a recap of 2020, because I just did a retrospective, which I highly recommend you go check that out. I did that as kind of like an annual review and reflection on what worked in 2020, what didn't work, and then what I plan on improving in 2021. And I think one thing I've been noticing lately, as the new year has been coming up, and as this year is coming to an end, and I see all these people maybe posting shit they got done throughout 2020, or these big grand goals that they're ready to hit in 2021, just from the type of people that I like to follow, they're typically ambitious, highly successful people, at least as a majority, right? And I noticed that it actually created a little bit of anxiety for me, a little bit of negative emotions. I think given the pandemic and everything, and like my family's healthy, I'm healthy, and you know, I'm not worried about where my next meal is coming from. So for me in 2020, that is absolutely a win. However, I couldn't help but find myself looking at these ambitious accounts and feeling a little bit of anxiety, and honestly, a little bit of a punch to my self-worth. Now, I don't think that it is valid. I am proud of who I am as an individual, but I think that there's still a lot of work left to be done. And I think that if you're also an ambitious person, which I'm sure that you are, seeing as how you're listening to this in the first place, you can probably relate to me whenever you feel like you could always improve, right? And I think that that's kind of a double-edged sword. I think it's good to feel like you always have something to improve. You're always trying to better yourself, right? But I think whenever you begin to compare yourself to other people with completely different experience, life circumstances, luck, etc., it can be a very dangerous game. And I think what can happen is we can get sucked into, and this is what happened with me, I can get sucked into watching the amazing lives of other people, and I forget about building my own amazing life. Or I get too caught up in comparing myself to others instead of focusing on my own shit, right? And I think that I'm happy with what I did in 2020. It was a lot of strategizing. It was a lot of deep thinking. It was a lot of reflecting and figuring out which direction I really want to take things. And I think 2021, is going to be different in the sense that now it is time to act on that thinking, right? Because I think as a person who loves to take in a lot of information, who loves personal development, and I love these different thought experiments and learning from different people and taking habits, routines, decision-making processes, mental models, whatever you want to call it, from all these really smart people, and then try to apply it to my life. But what I've found happening as of late, especially towards the end of the year, when it's kind of just built for passiveness, right? Like you just kind of like, okay, I just need to get through this, all the holidays and stuff. It's kind of built for downtime. And then whenever the New Year's hits, that's whenever people want to flip the switch. And I think that's what's actually creating a little bit of this anxiety for me, is because I'm doing a lot of thinking and taking in information and then also comparing myself to other people. However, I'm not objectively acting on anything to change it. That's not to mean I'm sitting on my ass or anything like that, but not to the standard that I hold myself. I hope that makes sense, because I think that we all set these standards of what we should or shouldn't do. And whenever we fail to uphold that standard, that's whenever these negative emotions can start to come in. I think it was Mark Manson who said that negative emotions are simply a call to action. And I think that that's what 2020 has really shown me. And I hope that's what 2020 is going to show a lot of you, is that these negative emotions, especially as the year comes to the end and you see other people that have thrived during this time, and maybe you've had a difficult time, it can bring up these uncomfortable emotions. But I think to me, all that means is that now is the time to do something about it. And so I could, because I think that with information, it's information is only as good as the action you take after learning about it, right? And I think that is what's key. So information is only as good as the action you take after learning it. And so with that said, I think that 2021 is going to be the year of intentional action. And I think that that is how we battle with these negative emotions, right? Because if negative emotions are a call to action, it means we actually have to do something. We can't think our way to the other side, right? We actually have to do something on a regular basis. So that means we have to figure out what our values are, figure out what our goals are, and then we have to take the daily actions to get us closer and closer to those values, and so that we can go to sleep every night being proud of who we are, right? Because I think that's what a lot of success really is, right? You're able to sleep well at night. Whenever you lay your head on the pillow, you feel good about it. And I think what is missing from me, what was missing from 2020, which was purposeful, because you can't do everything all at the same time. I think 2020 was laying the foundation, doing a lot of planning and strategizing, and 2021 is going to be the year of intentional action on those things that I say that is important to me. So maybe you're in the same boat, or maybe you have to do the direction planning first. Maybe you have to do the strategizing and a lot of reflection and internal soul searching and figure out what the hell it is that you actually want. And then maybe that's what 2021 is for you. Or maybe you're in the same boat as me and you're ready to actually take some action. I think that you need to do a little bit of both, but if you just take a bunch of random action in a direction that's not meaningful, you're going to end up in a place that isn't where you want to be. And then you might look back and think, oh my God, I just did all of that shit for no reason. Right. So I think it's important to figure out which direction you need to go, figure out where you need to steer the ship. And then whenever you figure that out, or at least how you figure that out in the moment, because that's going to be dynamic, that's going to change. Maybe in 2 months, I think, okay, I need to move the ship a couple degrees this way, as opposed to what I thought it was. And that's totally fine. You're just adapting to the situation. However, I think that you have to first pick a direction, and then all of your effort, all of your focus, all of your attention has to go 100% in that direction if you want to take your shit to the next level. I think that's what it takes. So yeah, 2021, the year of intentional action. And I think that we are going to wrap it up there with Minisode number 100. I'm going to throw these 6 shades on that I can only wear because it's December 30th at the time of recording this. I've got basically a day and a half, 2 days-ish to continue wearing these sick 2020 shades. But that is it, ladies and gentlemen, 100 Minisodes. Thank you guys for being here. I really, really, really do appreciate you. And let's finish the year strong. Thank you guys, as always, for listening and for watching. See ya.